Hello and welcome back, anybody, everybody, but probably nobody. This is once again ThorW bringing you another episode of Let's Play Dark Souls. In our last episode, we went through the Ulysseal Township proper and made our way down through into the dungeon and down into the chasm of the abyss. Actually, why am I down here? Oh, that's right. I was farming a little bit of humanity between episodes. So I'm going to head back to the township. I'm going to take the shortcut that we opened up in our last episode, which was buy Marvelous Chester before we murdered him in cold blood. Or, you know, he invaded us. He wanted to kill us for our humanity. I mean, what? He was a jerk. I'm not going to let him just try and kill me and get away with that. I mean, come on. Come on now. There is no mercy. No mercy live on pay-per-view. I see. I think it was over there. Was the shortcut. Anyway, down in the Chasm of the Abyss, we found out that Sif had journeyed there with Artorias and attempted to fight against the Abyss with him, and unfortunately did not do terribly well. Oh, this is the wrong one. My bad, guys. My bad. It's the other one. Obviously. If it's not this one, it's the other one. My bad, I went to the wrong one. My memory escapes me sometimes. I'm a dummy. I'm a dummy. Anyway, based on what we found, Artorias sacrificed himself in order to save Sif. If you actually come to Ulysseal before you fight Sif in Darkroot Garden, which you can do, but you will not be able to meet Darkstalker Koth at all, and I felt like meeting him was... Oh god, framerate. I felt like meeting him was a little bit more important than getting a minor cutscene difference. But if you do that and you save Sif prior to fighting him at Artorias' grave in Darkroot Garden, then... Oh jeez. These big guys, they're tough. Then you get a different cutscene in which Sif will knock you down and he'll sniff you. And he'll recognize your scent from the time you save him. And he will let out a very, very depressed howl, slowly pick up his sword and ready himself for a fight that he doesn't want to fight. He really doesn't want to fight you because you're the guy that A, saved him from the abyss, B, let Artorias' soul rest in peace. Ah, jeez, I keep running into these guys. This sword's not the great... Katanas are not... At least, the Uchi Katana's not the greatest in the world for facing these enemies. Anyway, the different cutscene you get is a minor thing, but it's a very good touch that they added to the game once they added this DLC. Just the very fact that you can get a different cutscene is really cool. Alright, yeah, okay. And we're gonna grab this once we murder you. Ow, she touched me! Ew! Humanity. Now there is a carving down here somewhere. Why'd I drink? I had so much health. What's wrong with me? There's another carving down here. I think it's the I'm sorry carving? If I recall correctly. Much like the very good carving we found earlier. These things can be a little bit annoying to fight. It's very easy to just step into them and get hit. Especially with a weapon like this, the reach isn't the greatest in the world on the Uchi Katana. Like a great sword is very good for going through these guys, because there's no big dodge rolls or difficulty in hitting them. It's all about swinging at a distance and being able to hit them without walking into them, basically. Anyway, as for lore behind the Humanity Phantoms, there kind of isn't any, and their name is Humanity Phantoms, as far as anyone can tell, really. In case you were wondering. Anyway, what they're doing is they are sitting over here. Is this the drop I'm thinking of? God, I don't want to just kill myself. There's a drop somewhere. Maybe that was the drop. I can't remember the exact position of everything in this damn place because it's so dark. Oh, there it is. It's the help me carving. Help me. Very fitting for this area. Plunging attack. And it drops you right down onto the black flame, which is, it's basically combustion with the magic of Ula Seal darkness there. Disasters are gone after the defeat of the Grave Lord Servant. What the hell? What Grave Lord Servant? I didn't summon no Grave Lord Servant. Okay, nice message, guys. Thanks for that. You confused me thoroughly. And I think I've gotten everything I can from Ula Seal spell-wise and actual item-wise. Here, it says, because this is the place we have to head towards. You guys gonna come this way? No? Okay. Let me see. Where exactly is it that I have to head? I'm just using this for light right now. I think it's this way, then. Hi, guy. So, anyway, regarding the Humanity Phantoms again, there's, like, no info on them, basically. Oh, yeah, it's from above. Okay, yeah. But they drop humanities, they drop twin humanities. It's a good place to farm humanity. Equip the covetous gold serpent ring. If you have, like, 10 soft humanity is the cap for increasing your item find with soft humanity. I kind of have to sneeze, but it's not coming! Ugh. But if you meet those parameters and you come here and you just murder a bunch of humanity phantoms, you will get a bunch of humanity. Which is kind of why I'm doing this next, because there's a couple things that I need to take care of that involve having a lot of humanity. Now it's time to try and remember where the freak I have to go. And I can't remember where the freak I have to go. So this is where we got Puppy Sif. Pretty sure there's like a big thing to slide down somewhere. Somewhere. Is it here? If I start getting too lost, I will cut forward. But I don't think this will take me too long to figure out. I think I have the mental capacity to do it. I might be wrong, though. Might be entirely wrong about my own mental capacity and capabilities. Oh, jeez. I'm about to head in circles. No, don't start going in circles. That's the first step to losing. Oh, God. Oh, no, I'm getting lost. Getting lost, and I have no clue what I'm supposed to do. Jeez, this is bad. This looks bad. This reflects poorly on my capabilities of navigation. See, if there's one thing that I'm bad at, it's navigation. And, oh. Dark Souls has it sometimes where it's like, oh man, do you know where to go? No, I don't know where to go. You know where to go? I don't know where to go. I don't have any clue where the fuck to go. I'm gonna run backwards. Oh, also, we're gonna look like Marvelous Jester as we go and fight Manus. Once I have a clue where the fuck I'm going. Oh, no! No! Don't look at me! Don't look at me and how lost I am! I got lost in the fucking depths! How am I supposed to make my way around this place? It's so dark! Oh, no. Oh, God, no. Is it this way? No, that's not. Wait. It is this way! Haha, I did it! I'm a genius! I've never been lost before in my entire life. Don't worry about it, guys. I don't think there's anything over here. Nope, there's nothing over there. Anyway, this is your part. It's the big triple. These lights are there specifically only to make sure you know where to go. I don't think there's like any lore purposes behind them. Other than maybe Artorias lit the way so that he would know where to go through the chasm of the abyss. Don't know. don't particularly know. Yep, there it is. Twin humanities, nothing major. Yeah, but Dark Souls likes to hide things. FromSoft, I should say. FromSoft, in all of their games, likes to hide things under things and behind things when you pass by them. So down there you can see the fog door to Manus himself. And I'm gonna try and see something. Hopefully I'll be able to. Hi there. Ah, I walked into him. Damn it. A white titanite slab. Those are quite rare. Quite rare indeed. In fact, let's look at it just for lore purposes. There we go. White titanite slab for reinforcement. Legendary slabs were the domain of the gods. Reinforced divine weapons to +10 and occult weapons to +5. Legendary slabs are the heirlooms of a nameless blacksmith deity who forged the weapons of other gods. Weapons forged with this slab become rare legendary weapons. Anyway, the chunks talk about slabs as myth, as possibly myths. And yeah, shards talk about them just as a thing to reinforce. Dragon scale. Dragons inseparable from its scales, and the transcendent apostles who seek the perpetuity of the ancient dragons have crossed the very ends of the earth to seek this invaluable treasure. And when the nameless blacksmith deity passed from several slabs, great beasts arose. The power of titanite remains within them, and they still roam Lordran today. Finally, after this titanite was peeled from its slab, it is said it received special power, but its specific nature is not clear. I never read through those. I'm sorry to just bombard you guys with that right now. But, you know, the Chasm of the Abyss, clearly the best place in the world to be talking about the upgrade material. But I never read through them, and I felt bad for not doing so. And that's our first slab to actually find. Try humanity. Which is a good point. There is a summon sign for this fight. It doesn't appear until you are actually in the fight, though. It appears in the arena against Manus. You can summon in Sif as your teammate, as your partner. God damn it, stop hitting me. And he's relatively helpful to have around. Soul of a hero. Let's go ahead and drink. We're pretty low on health here. Do I want another drink? Do I want to be full? I don't think I care. Need hope. Anyway, I'm gonna try and see if I can take a look there. Is it here, I think? At one of these angles... Maybe it's not this angle. Maybe it's from a different one completely. But at one of these angles, I'm not 100% sure exactly where. You can take a look with a... You can look with, like, a bow, too, and you can actually shoot him. You can see Manus before you even enter the fight. Which is kind of funny. You can kill him before you even enter the fight if you want. See, there's some writing down there that you can take a look at. But I don't know the exact angle for it. Sorry, guys. I'd love to show it off, but I've never actually looked for it before. Is that... Are those his feet? There's his eyes. See his eyes down there in the corner? It's really hard to see, and the angle's difficult to get, but you can see his... You could see his beady little eyes, not the writing. His beady little eyes are down there, and I think you need, like, a... You need the Hawk Ring. Yeah, there he is. Right down there. Right down there, below my health bar, above, between the health bar and the Great Chaos Fireball, almost exactly. That's where Manus is kind of just chilling. You can actually shoot him with a bow from a specific angle, and you can kill him before you even fight him if you want to, or you can bring him down to like one hit if you feel like it, to cheese out the fight, but I'm not going to do that. Alright, so this is a relatively difficult fight. Do forgive me if I die. I'm going to switch this out to something more useful. None of these are especially useful. The most useful would actually be the Ring of Favor and Protection, which... Eh. Interesting thing to note, you don't need the Covenant of Artorias to walk down in here and fight Manus, even though it's kind of technically in the Abyss. Just really, it's interesting. It's interesting and odd. Yeah, might as well get that. Helps versus physical attacks, which is him and his magic. Alright, so, traverse the white light, and we get our cutscene. That's great that we're Chester for this. Hi, Manus! So I've never died to Manus before, and seeing as this is a cursed recording, I'll be sure to die to him. Like 7-8 times, because I've never lost to him before. In fact, I've beaten him 40 levels below what I'm at, so this should be fun to die to him for once. Okay. He's very vulnerable after that. It's usually good to only get one attack in, rather than go for two. Oh. He's, well, trying to talk and play at the same time. Like most enemies in Ulysseal, especially the bosses, he's extremely aggressive. I got hit by that, which I shouldn't have. Ow. I thrust between his legs. I could not hit him there. That was early. Alright. I'm not talking much because I'm kind of trying to concentrate because I've been just garbage lately at this game when I'm recording, and I'd like to do slightly better for you guys. Okay, so that's his indication that he's going to do a big six-string combo attack, as you can see. It does a lot of damage if it hits. It will break through your stamina very quickly. It's ill-advised to block it. It's just better to dodge. I should have dodged sideways so I could have hit him. Like that. He generally tends to jump back after you hit him, so it's usually relatively safe. 4, 5, 6. Fireball. Oh, he dodged. Good dodge by him. Oh. Ow. Yep. Did it twice. That's very fast. Anyway, this is a very large arena to fight Manus in, so do feel free to roll around a lot. If you are playing along at home. Okay, so he started casting spells. That's the worst one for him to do. That one's difficult to dodge. Aw, fuck! I'm dead. Yep. Oh, I mistimed my roll. That was a bad roll. Bad roll. Hey, remember when I said I've never died to Manus before? Oh, wonderful. Oh, great. Now I have to run all the way back through. Alright, so I'm going to crunch a little bit of humanity. That way I can just have this ready, because I'm probably going to die a lot, knowing me. Never died to Manus before, ever in my life, so I'm recording, so I'm going to die to him a lot. I don't know why. I just am. Everyone, hold your hands up and send me your power. I'm gonna need it, because for some reason I can't do this on my own whenever you're watching. It's kind of weird. I know people are watching, so I must play poorly. That's how it works. Let's see the exact pathing that I have to go. Down here. Hi, guy. Alright, so because this is a long path, this is the only path walking secondary path, second time going through, whatever you want to say, goddammit. Words, English, language, difficult. This is the only time I'm going to show myself walking down the path a second time. because it will get very tedious if I have to do it anymore. Anyway, here's her. You fucking bitch! She casts Dark Fog, so whatever. She has an angle on that. That's good to know. That's wonderful to know. I will kill her this time. Never mind, this is the last time that I'm actually going to show myself running down there. Yeah, sorry about that death. That was a dumb one. That was literally the dumbest death in the history of dumb deaths. I want to be human just once. I've actually never summoned Sif into this fight. So, we'll do that again. At this point in time, I have zero regard for how much humanity I do or do not have in my item-wise, because I can farm it forever now that I've got this place open to me. Farm it as much as I want, whenever I want, anytime that I want, and I will be sure to do so when I feel like it. Sheesh, I can't be taking this much fucking time on Manus. I got another asshole of a boss to go kill too. Then I gotta talk with Gogh for a while. Gogh. I don't know how to pronounce it, but I'm gonna keep doing it with a hard Gaelic. Oh, you fucking bitch. There we go. Since I know she still has an angle on me, she proved it earlier. Alright, I think I'm fine. I don't think she can hit me anymore. Also, the silver pendant, you can use that against Manus when he shoots out those dark orbs at you. It does block the magic of the abyss. No matter who's shooting it at you. Wow, I took a lot of damage from that. Surprising amount of damage. Alright. Oh, new messages. We'll just go in there full, why not? I think Sif's summon sign is like right at the beginning of the fight. We can skip that. Where is it? It's around here somewhere. I don't know where it is though. That's kind of a problem. With wanting to use a summon sign but having no clue where it is. Oh, nice roll. Good job, Thor. Oh, there it is. It's at the side. Let's summon him in. They do something nice, which is they just, there's no confirmation for summoning him. There's just a summon. Oh, he went for Sif there, I think. Either that or just way jumped over me. Manus is actually very predictable overall, so he's not hard to beat. Ow. That one's a little bit harder to predict overall, compared to his usual hits. I'm gonna be a man and not have my shield anymore. So honestly, I should have like the grass crest shield on my back instead. Oh, wait. Fuck, 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 shit, shit, fuck. Drink. Ow. Sif, you wanna do anything, guy? Oh, this is bad. However, that is really fucking cool, so showing that off is fine for me. I'm fine with showing that off because it looks so cool. Ow. Alright, if I could stop, please. Me. Alright, I crunched a humanity because it's a full heal rather than two Estus to not full heal. Fuck, really? That still hit. Ah, stop it, please. That's actually not too bad. That's not the best one that he could do. Neither is that. Alright, I need to get in there. I'm, not really fighting him, I'm just kind of dodging stuff. And he's done. He's not a very difficult fight. I could have done it without Sif, too. Sif kind of distracted him for, like, 2 seconds. That's the extent of what you did. You are a bad dog. You were not very good at fighting. God damn it. And here's Dusk. Wake up, Dusk. So yeah, that's pretty much what she's gonna do for a bit. Talk to me! Notice, Senpai! Notice me! Notice me! I'm the one that saved you! Me! Eh, whatever. I did it! Good job, guy. You did it. Aw, oh, yeah. I did it. Everyone did it. Yay. Anyhoozles, that was a Manus, the primeval man. Let's go ahead and take a look at his soul, since we have it. Look, notice it is a dark soul, a completely black soul. The soul of Artorias is stained because it is corrupted by the Abyss, but Manus's is pure pitch black. Soul of Manus, father of the Abyss. This extraordinary soul is a viscous, lukewarm lump of gentle humanity. Ancient Manus was clearly once human, but he became the father of the Abyss, and his humanity went wild, eternally seeking his precious broken pendant. No clue why he's seeking the broken pendant, but he is. Dusk, I have Manus's soul. Does that turn you on? Whatever. Whatever. Alright, so there's nothing else to do down here. We get a little bonfire to warp from. You can actually warp to this bonfire if ever you wish to. This is actually a decent arena for, like, PvPing people. The sanctuary... I believe Elizabeth has some words for us for saving Dusk. So we're gonna go and, have words with her.
I have awaited thee. Thou hast rescued Princess Dusk and rid us of that terrible primeval human, even halting the spread of the Abyss. I salute the grandeur of thine enterprise. Please allow me to express my gratitude. I thank thee, as do we all.
And she gives us 3 Elizabeth mushrooms, which, as you recall, is a healing item.
I will remember thee, but I will keep thy story to myself. This is the best way, for thou art come from a time far ahead. No one will sing thy praises, but yet thy greatness shall live on, for it shall be my purpose to remember all thou hast done for us. Was thine eye glancing hither? Thou needst not hide thy wonder. I am a mushroom, after all.
Right, so yeah, her,
may the flames guide thee.
She's like, yeah, I'll remember your story, and your glory will live on. But no, because Ulysseel gets completely destroyed. The story is that Artorias walked the abyss and stopped the spread of it by sacrificing himself. So no, my story won't live on because you kicked the bucket. You'd die way before my time. So whatever, we're going to be basically a thankless hero for that. Good for us. We're good guys. Yay!
Yay us! Yay! We're so nice.
Anyway, a couple notes about Manus himself. Is that, Manus, the, primeval man, as he is referred to as, theorized by many to be the furtive pygmy. And it makes sense. You know, the original inheritor of the Dark Soul would somewhat explain why the soul is a ball of gentle humanity, as it was described. I believe there's an item back here. Yep. Just a soul of a hero, though. Nothing major. And because of that, because of the appearance, everything kind of lines up for the furtive pygmy to have been Manus. And we saw that Manus was horribly warped into a weird, disgusting monster from residing in the abyss and being consumed by dark. So, I think that's a very prime example of heed chest. Actually, that's a good one, because you have to kill a mimic to get the crest key. It's a pretty prime example of why the Age of Dark would not be very good for people. The whole of Ulysseel, Manus as well. Anyway, this is Hawkeye Golf. We'll go ahead and talk with him.
A visitor, have we? Thou must be the one who freed Artorias. That old friend he was. Thanks to thee, he left this world with honor intact. And here I am, retired and blind. Of little help to thee, I'm afraid. If thou seeketh to explore this domain, be wary of a black dragon. I fear thee no match for this terrible beast.
So he's talking about Black Dragon Kalameet, who we briefly met on the stone bridge on the way over here. He kind of stopped, looked at us, gave us the stink eye, and then flew off. Like, what, you want to do something? Because he thinks he's a badass.
There's very little to be said. What good is a dog with no hares to hunt? But I'm lucky to be alive, I suppose.
So he's mainly talking about the fact that he was this is Hawkeye Gaul. He was the great archer, one of Gwyn's four knights, who is said to have been able to bring down dragons in mid-flight with a single arrow, which would be a lot easier with a bow that big and arrows as large as he would be wielding, considering his large size and prodigious strength given it. So what he's referring to is there are no more dragons for him to hunt, for the most part. There's very, very few left. At this point, there is Seath, there is Kalameet. If we go by Dark Souls 2 lore and stuff existing, there's like one more actual dragon out there in the world, kind of slumbering and, you know, chilling. And that's just about it in the way of actual dragons. That's why he's saying that, you know, he's like very retired and done. Alright, so that's all he's got to say for the time being. He sells the hello carving, which I'm going to take. The thank you carving. These are very cheap. They're only 5. I love them. These carvings are great. Titanite shards, large titanite, green titanite. So nothing unique there. And he sells Golf's great arrows. I think he might be the only person that sells these. Great arrow used by Hawkeye Gaul, one of Lord Gwyn's four knights. For Dragon Slayer, requires a great bow. Golf personally crafts each stone tip and wraps the shaft tightly with tree bark. So he makes all of his own arrows, which is why he's so good at these carvings and makes all these stone
Farewell,
carvings.
Human. Lead thy life as thou seest fit.
So that's why he's up here doing that. It's kind of interesting that he's imprisoned up here on a tower. And it's kind of hard to tell whether he was imprisoned here by the citizens of Ulusil, whether he decided he wanted to go hang here for a while and just lock himself away from others, seeing as he basically sees his job as done completely, because, you know, not many dragons left in the world. So, for the most part, he's relatively content where he is. It's hard to say whether he was locked there by the citizens of Ulusil. Wait, maybe the key will tell us. Grooves on the crest are enchanted, the door sealed with a powerful spell. Nope. Nothing. So yeah, not a whole lot of info on that, unfortunately. I wish there was a little bit more backstory as to why he is here, and why he is in a prison, essentially. Anyhoozles, we have yet more business here in Ulusil, and this kind dead fellow is here to light the way and show us the exact path that we need to walk down. And there's an item back there to pick up as well, so we'll go for it. Unfortunately, this place is infested with the most horrifying creature known to man, dogs. So these work exactly the same as all dogs do. They're very fast, they jump around a lot, they cause bleed buildup, they're annoying as all hell. And I hate them. I hate them with a fiery burning passion. I hate the dogs. And we got a large soul of Brave Warrior. Large souls of Brave Warriors, I think, are the best souls that you can get outside of boss souls in regards to how many souls they give when you crush them in your hand. Anyway, there's more dogs here. These dogs are Abyss dogs, in case you're wondering exactly what their name is and everything. These are dogs tainted by the Abyss. They were probably already hostile before the Abyss tainted them. All it did was it kind of made them darker. They are literally just a reskin of an earlier enemy. There's nothing special about them, unfortunately. You'd think there would be, considering, you know, they're Abyss dogs. Like, they could spit Abyss or something, but they just do everything that the old dogs do. As far as I know, at least, I've never had one spit anything at me or anything like that, so. As far as I'm concerned, these things are not unique in any way, shape, or form. Need sniper. So let's go ahead and, well, first I'm going to show off. Black Dragon Kalameet is here. This is where he likes to hang on Friday evenings. You can also slip down here and you can get this tight night lizard if you want to. Imminent resignation, imminent grief, yeah, pretty much. If you try to climb down here, and I think he'll just, he'll come by and do it on his own if I sit on the ladder. I'll give it a few seconds, and if not, I'll go down there and I'll just get my ass handed to me real quick. Kalameet, come on, guy. Hello? Alright, fine. You win, you stupid dragon. I'm waiting for you. Watch him come from this side. He's supposed to trigger. He is supposed to trigger up there on the fucking ladder, let alone down here. Come on now. Alright. Well, I'm just gonna climb back up, because I don't feel like getting instant one-shot by him right now. But what he's supposed to do is, when you go down there, he's supposed to fly through and burn the entire area with his dark flame. Which, you know, usually he's fucking happy to do so, but right now he seems a little resigned and a little shy. I don't know why. But, anyway, I'm gonna head back to Hawkeye Gaul. I think I already triggered enough to get what I need out of him. Because In case you haven't noticed, Black Dragon Kalameet is the next boss for us to go have a talk with. We're going to have a stern talking to with him. He's been very naughty. Very naughty indeed. Anyway, you're supposed to have the trigger point of him flying in and burning the place. I don't know if this will work or not. If it doesn't, I might just make a cut right back to save some time, or I might subject you all to watching me run down there again. Because I have to deal with it. Why not you? Huh? Huh? You think this is some sort of game? You think this is some sort of game for your leisure? Well, yes it is, so... Even so, I am the master, I am the puppeteer here, you are all my puppets, and you will watch everything that I do, whether you want to or not. Welcome to the Salty Spittoon. How tough are you? How tough am I? How tough am I? I had a bowl of nails for breakfast. Just so. Without any milk. Oh, right this way. Alright, Gaul, you gonna do it?
Black Dragon posing the duress?
Yes.
Yes. I thought as much. He's called Kalameet. Ferocious dragon indeed. Even mighty Analanda dared not provoke his ire. I see little good coming from this, but thy intent is to persevere to the bitter end?
Yes.
Good. What is bravery without a dash of recklessness? I've taken a liking to thee, and I owe thee much for thy service to Artorias. Now, watch, and see how Gorf hunts dragon.
Gorf, okay. I have been pronouncing it wrong. Gorf. Alright, so... One thing to note, Gorf mentioned he is blind. He's also very covered in dust, because he hasn't moved... Covered in wood carving shavings, I should say. As someone who has done woodworking before, you get plastered in that stuff if you sit there working with wood for a while. So let's go ahead and see how Gorf hunts dragons.
Was never loosed. That bat will be grounded for a good spell. The rest is in thine hands. I await good tidings. Ah, dragon slaying. Knighthood's highest calling.
So it's obvious through his dialogue, Gorf is a very honorable fellow. He took his duty as a knight well. He enjoyed, doing the duty. He liked being a dragon slayer and everything.
Ah, hello there. What of Kalameet? He is an ancient dragon. Skyward or no, he will not be put down easily. Dragons shall never be forgotten. We knights fought valiantly, but for every one of them, we lost 60 of our own. Exhilaration, pride, hatred, rage. The dragons teased out our dearest emotions. Thou will understand one day. At thy twilight, old thoughts return in great waves of nostalgia. That's very... What good is it that I'm lucky to be alive, Farewell, human. I await good tidings.
Right. So he gives a little bit of a backstory into how really, really difficult the fight against the dragons was. For every one dragon they took down, they lost 60 of their own. And this is with the combined efforts of Lord Gwyn, Nido, the Witch of Izalith, Seath, the entirety of Gwyn's army of lords, Gwyn's four knights, all of those, the army of the undead, which, or at least whatever army that Nido may or may not have been able to control back then. There wasn't much backstory on whether he had an army of the undead for that fight. The rest of the pyromancers of Izalith, the witches of Izalith, the daughters of chaos, all of those together, and still they talk about the fight against the ancient dragons as if it was barely won. And even now there's like an ancient dragon here or there still living that they don't want to fight because it's like, man, fuck that. Alright, so a couple notes on this situation with Kalameet. You can actually kill Kalameet without ever having Goff ground him. You don't have to go through that. However, it will take a great deal of arrows, a great many of them, to kill him. You can't ground him yourself. He will fly by and you'll have a chance to shoot him. That's about it. It's very time-consuming, and I believe you are not rewarded with any souls for doing it. You do get different dialogue from Goff if you do it that way, though. So, there's the interest of that. Anyway, the fight against Kalameet will not begin until I go down there, because he's hanging off to the side over this way, which I don't think I can see him from any angle. I'm going to take a step back and take a looky-loo. Nope. He's back around the corner. So, let's go down there and let's go greet Kalameet. This fight is a little bit difficult, so do forgive me. I do expect to die on this once or twice. Not a very easy fight. Kalameet is a badass. Alright, let's go, guy. Let me try and get his patterns down real quick before I forward swipe, forward charge. This is a good one. You can also take his tail, which I'm going to try to do. Charge forward plus fire, straight fire. Forward charge, another one. Come on. I need you to do something that will let me hit your tail. If you would be so kind, I think that might do it. I think I need to be able to get behind him, which isn't easy. Because he does stuff like that constantly. I will get this motherfucker's tail. Trust me. Oh! Ah, shoot. Slow roll. Don't get hit. Try not to get hit by his fire. It does a lot of damage. Come on, charge me. Charge me, you bitch! I want your tail. Come on. No, that ain't gonna do it. Not. Come on. Up in the air. Up in the air, you cycloptic motherfucker! Ah, shoot. Ow. That did a lot. Like I said, don't get hit by his fire. It hurts a lot. I should have side-rolled there. Come on. That might be my best chance to get behind him. Okay, for that one, he flies straight up and blows fire right beneath himself. It's the It's his counterplay to someone is underneath me. Oh, goddammit. I don't want to be in the water to fight him, because my movement is impaired if I am. I need him to do something now. That'll work. Never mind, that didn't work. He landed on me. There's a lot of things in this fight that can go wrong, especially in trying to get his tail. Getting his tail is fucking hard. So, do excuse my multiple attempts at doing so. Oh, crud. Did not roll. Oh. Running low on Estus here. Let me hit your tail, come on, man. I guess we're playing Ring Around the Rosie until one of us gives up. Oh no! Okay. Come on, you bitch, let me behind you. Let me behind you. No, I wasn't quick enough. Come on, do it again. Damn it, not that. Come on, do it again. Rear up. Rear up again, you f- Come on, rear up. Rear up. That ain't it. I'm really trying to get him to do that rear up attack. That rear up flame breath. Come on. If he does that, I have a very good chance. That's a grab. That's an ear-splitting grab. Tail swipe. Come on. That's not the right one. Come on, you bitch. Come on. Kalameet. You can roll that every time. You're not going to hit me with it. Oh. That hit me? Okay, then. I had the animation wrong. That's what I want. Alright. Yeah, that's a good combo. That's what I want him to do. That's the other thing I want him to do. I'll roll it every time, Kalameet. There it is. Oh, it's so hard to get behind him in time. Come on. This is going to be a little bit of a long fight, as you can tell, because I'm trying to get his tail. It ain't easy. Oh, that's bad. Okay, not as bad as it could have been. Perfect. Tail. Stomp your tail back. Oh. Fuck you. I couldn't get out of the way. I think I could have rolled it if I rolled better. Come on. Not that. Not what I'm looking for. Come on, Kalameet. There you go. Right. Yeah, that was bad. I didn't have full stamina. Because I didn't have full stamina, he hit me. The way that works is that if you do have full stamina... Oh god, I didn't sit at the township, god damn it. The way that works is if I have full stamina, it will roll me backwards, but I'll get the block off, which is the very important part of it. And then I'm right behind him, and then I want him to throw his tail down. I panicked because I got hit and I did an early roll, so we're gonna try this one more time without cutting, and, you know, if... It takes us multiple tries. It's very difficult to get certain tails off of certain dragons. Kalameet is one of them. Seath is actually another one of them, and only because of the way that Seath's tail is designated. The area that is designated as Seath's tail. Mainly because it can clip through the wall all the time. You know, I went through it while I was fighting against Seath. Anyway, as for Kalameet, I have never seen a summon sign around this guy. I don't think anyone ever goes to get summoned in against Kalameet for some reason. Not sure why. I mean, it's not like he's a... I think he's a fun fight. I don't think he's a super undesirable fight to go to. Oh, you stupid dog! I hate these things! Hate you. I hate you, you dog. Alright, so once again, we're going to do our strategy of... He needs to do either one of those two attacks. He needs to either do the tail slam, which generally only comes if you're far behind him, and if he's already charged at you, or he has to rear up and breathe fire, which is still hard to get behind him in time. Alright, Kalameet, do one of the moves I want you to. Come on. That ain't it. Okay, I didn't roll it. I guess I won't roll it every single time like I should. Come on. Not it. Also not it. Come on. I'm waiting for very specific attacks, and that's all I'm gonna wait for. There we go, there's one. Slam your tail. I missed my chance because I rolled again. Oh, I should have only single rolled. I'm dumb. Alright, I missed one opportunity. It's going to take several to get them, so it's fine. Alright, slam your tail. Damn. Come on, Kalameet. Come on. Come on, buddy. Come on. There you go. Alright. Come on. Ow. Really? Okay. I shouldn't have rolled back. Alright, it's time to start cuts. Wonderful. Amazing. Tremendous. I'm the best in the world. Oh. Cool. Wonderful. Oh, now you're gonna... Oh, fuck you! If that kills... Oh my god! You will give me your tail. I don't care how many attempts it takes or how difficult it is. You will give me your stupid fucking tail, and I will shake it in your goddamn face as I plunge my sword deep into your single cycloptic fucking eye and rip your head off and show it to you! Somehow. Oh my god, really? Wonderful. Tremendous. Terrific. Great job, Kalameet. We're gonna be here for like four more fucking hours trying to beat this. Trying to get his tail, not even beat him. I could fucking easily beat him. I need the goddamn tail. Yeah, do that. Start off. Start off strong, Kalameet. I can only get one swing in, though. That sucks. Come on. Come on, you asshole! Come on! Come on, Kalameet! Come on! Come on, 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 come on! Come on! Just fucking do it! Great, wonderful, it didn't do it because I got hit by nothing. I hit by his fucking foot somehow. Oh, great. Wonderful. Get in the air! Come on. Yes, you look cool. Quit doing it. We get it, you're a cool black dragon. Come on. Fly. Fly, you pussy. I dare you. I fucking dare you to get up in the air and charge me. You gonna try to grab me again? Is that why you're still walking at me? Nope. Come on. Do it, 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 do it. Wow, that hit me. Swing your tail. Oh, I wasn't right below his tail. Kalameet, where are you looking? Come on, man. Do it, 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 do it. Yes. Yes! I got your tail, you asshole! You're dead now! I have no qualms. I have nothing left to hold myself back from killing you. Nothing, Kalameet. Do you know what this means? Do you understand the gravity of the situation you're in? You're dead. You're about to die to a human, of all things. Yeah, you do your little fire attack. Tries to swing his tail. Oh, it's so cute. Ow. Hey, did you know I too can throw fire? See? I too can throw fire. It just kind of does nothing to him. Which is unfortunate. Okay, yeah, there we go. I played that one a little bit dangerous. No, please. I'm gonna need a little bit of time, please. That. Come on, Kalameet, give me what you got. That hurts so much. It's really bad. All Alright, that's fine. Alright, we'll switch to humanity because I'm out of Estus. I lost a lot of Estus getting this fucker's tail, but I think I got him on this one. So, to explain that grab, what that does is that doubles the damage you take for the rest of the fight. Very annoying to get hit by early on. If I can't lock onto him, I'm out of range. Okay, good. Come on, Kalameet, what are you gonna do? That's what I want you to do. Alright, I've almost got him. Okay, it took me a few tries, a few more than I wish it would have, because this guy's annoying to face multiple times. Oh, because his tail is so fucking hard to grab. That attack is actually bad for him to do now that he doesn't have a tail, because I got nothing for him to swing at me and get hit. However, it does leave him a little bit vulnerable here and there. Okay. No, he's not gonna launch. Okay. I'm gonna roll back. I'm gonna play this as safely as I can. Wow, that was a nice interaction. Hit me during my iframes. Iframes being invincibility frames, obviously. Almost got him. Almost got him. I think he's one hit away. One or two. One, maybe two. Got him! Fuck you, Kalameet! You're dead! You're done! It's over! I got him! Yes! Tremendous! Let's pick up this soul of a brave warrior. I think it's like soul of a hero and soul of a hero. Oh, yeah. Oh, my God. Yes! A dragon high above the sky, out of sight of the naked eye. Yep. Back we go to the bonfire. Oh my god, that took a while. Kalameet's tough. I don't have many qualms about dying to Kalameet. Let's go ahead and level up a little bit. As I said before, I'm gonna get a shit ton of strength now. Now let's go talk with Hawkeye Gulf, as he will have some new dialogue for us. And we're just about done with Ulysseal. Very close to being done with Ulysseal. Oh man. Kalameet is a tough fight when you're going for his tail. If you don't go for his tail, he's much easier. On my first attempt, the second I got his tail, killed him. Mainly because you gotta bait out you gotta bait out a very specific attack. It's so annoying. You guys know, you saw the montage.
Why? Thou hast defeated Kalameet? Wondrously played. Lord Gwyn's blessing upon me. That beast will never take to the skies again. This great bow? I shan't need it, but no dragons to hunt. I know not if a human could even operate it. But here, thy need outweighs mine.
So he awards us with his great bow, even though it's still right there.
I suspect thou hast taken a gander at it, but the dark of the abyss, which swallowed poor Artorias, threatens to devour our entire land of Ulysseal. It seems that this dire fate is unavoidable. But, seduced by a dark serpent or no, they awoke that thing themselves and drove it mad. One's demise is always one's own making. Now, do not mistake my words. I cherish my work. Wood carving is a nuanced art. I would have much to talk about with that blacksmith. In truth, how is the old chap, I wonder? Still hammering away, I should hope.
So he's referring to the blacksmith in Anor Londo, the giant blacksmith.
Farewell, proud human. May every honor be bestowed upon thee.
So, that's going to be the end of this episode. Thanks for watching, guys. We defeated Kalameet. We defeated Manus. So, I meant to actually be like, oh man. So much difficulty. That's what I meant. Yeah. And, joy. Because we finally beat it. We're done with Illusiel. So, yeah, we beat all the bosses and everything. So, nothing less to clean up. Thanks for watching, guys. I will see you in the next episode. Be sure to subscribe so you don't miss any more videos that I do. I will be doing, you know, I do them regularly. Every day. So, bye, guys. Thanks for watching. Man, I thanked you like 7 times. I'm a thankful guy. See ya!